11th chapter and the 40th verse. Jesus saith unto her, said not I unto thee, that thou, if thou wouldest believe, thou shouldest see the glory of God. Then they took away the stone from the place where the dead was laid. And Jesus lifted up his eyes and said, Father, I thank thee that thou hearest, hast heard me. And I knew that thou hearest me always, but because of the people which stand by, I said it, that they may believe that thou hast sent me. And when he had thus spoken, he cried with a loud voice, Lazarus, come forth. And he that was dead came forth, bound hand and foot, with grave clothes, and his face with the bound with a napkin. Jesus saith unto him, loose him, and let him go. You may be seated. And as we look at this, we have to ask the question today, church. What happens when you pray? Why pray? What's the purpose of prayer today? I mean, if you look at it, you know, people say, well, why do I pray? God knows everything anyway. Well, God knows everything. Yes, he does. But our part is to pray. To pray without ceasing. To lift up the name of the Lord. To lift the I'll just go into the message here in a minute. But as you know, we look and we see in the Garden of Gethsemane, Jesus prayed. Every turn he went, Jesus prayed. And he taught the disciples how to pray the Lord's Prayer. So prayer must be important if Jesus did it. A Christian means to be Christ-like. And if we're to be Christ-like, we're to be praying people. Right?
You're right.
So we need to pray. And if that song, there's another song that says, oh, every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I shall pray. And today, church, we need prayer in our life. It helps us. It guides us. It allows us to communicate with God. There's not a person in the world, if they have a good marriage, that they don't communicate with their spouse or their friends. But if you don't communicate, what happens? It deteriorates, it falls apart, you go your separate ways. So what do we need to do? We need to pray. Bible teaches us this. How should we pray? Wrote right here. Jesus said, I know thou hearest me always, but because of the people which stand before, by I said it, that thou may believe that thou hast sent me. But Jesus said this in the 41st, I thank thee thou hast heard me. We should pray in Jesus' name. Today, church is not a God, it's the God. It's not a name, it's the name. It's the only name that God will recognize in prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. And Jesus said in John, in the 14th chapter, the 14th verse, if you shall ask anything in my name, I will do it. Mm-hmm. So prayer if not in Jesus' name, is not prayer at all. So what do we need to do? We need to realize, first off, in order to be able to use Jesus' name, we need to be born again. To be born again is to accept Christ as Lord and Savior to your heart and to your soul. And then when we come to the Father, he says, him I recognize. Because he doesn't see us, he sees the blood of Jesus, and we come to him through Jesus. I heard something a while back that, and this is teaching going on out there in the United States today, that a wife had to go through her husband to get to the Father, to talk to God. I don't know where they got that doctrine from, but it's straight out of the pits of hell. See, today, church, we don't have to go through man. We're not Catholic. We're not Mormon. We're not any of these other religions. But we're Christians. We go through our mediator. We go through the high priest, Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, who will and always has answered our prayers according to the riches that he has in glory. All we got to do is go to him in Jesus' name. John 14, verse 6, he said, no man comes to the Father except by me. Comes unto the Father but by me. Excuse me, let's just get that right. In today, church, we can't go any other way. If there were another way, Jesus would not have died on the cross and would not have come back alive on the third day. for you and me, and those that are left behind will have a hard time. A prayer that leaves Jesus' name out is a prayer that dishonors Christ. Is it not?
Yes.
And think about it. It displeases God. How's that possible today? Today, church, is this because it is God's ordained way to come to Him. If we could have come any other way, Cain tried it and failed, right?
Mm-hmm.
Nimrod tried it and failed. All these men of the Bible tried it. Men today have tried it. They tried the God of money. They tried the God of this. They tried the God of that. And they've all failed. But for 6,000 years, nearly 7,000 years now, God on this earth has reigned supreme. Yes, I'm one of those who believes the earth is 7,000 years old.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all can argue with me if you want, but that's already settled in my heart.
Mm-hmm.
That's a different sermon.
Mm-hmm.
We should pray in a forgiving spirit.
Right.
Mark 11:25, and when you stand praying, forgive. If you have aught against any, that your Father also which is in heaven may forgive you your trespasses. That's a big step right there. Lord, why don't you answer my prayers? Could it be that we have an unforgiving heart? We need a forgiving heart in order that the Lord may forgive us. How can we love God who we have not seen if we don't love our brother who we have seen? See, today, church, as we go through this life, we're going to get hurt. We're going to be ridiculed. We're going to go through everything. The Bible says, in this world you shall have tribulation. And we do. But He said, be of good cheer, for I have overcome the world. That means He has given us the ability to overcome the hurt. To be able to forgive those that despitefully use us, that we might be able to imitate Christ in every aspect of our lives.